各位观众朋友大家好，欢迎收看看军文学英语，我是 Amy， 透过军事新闻一起学习英文用语。今天带大家看到乌克兰的防空与无人机作战正改变着军用直升机的战术本质，它将载体的重心从矛头的尖端导向加强支援前线的战术任务。这种改变多半是因为地面防空激增，导致战区内无法执行载人飞行。在2024年，由于防空系统的威胁与饱和，前线直升机的主要任务变成沿战斗前线执行火力支援，采用弹跳轰炸战术、非导引无瞄准打击，同时遂行反制无人武器。战斗直升机的脆弱性从俄军巨大的损失可见一斑。一份伦敦国际学院战略研究报道指出，俄国空军 KA-52 短吻俄攻击直升机连队损失达 40%，俄国的损失接二连三，然而战术上的改变及新武器之引进已见成效。或许攻击直升机该演化为战区外武器，以利直升机从较远距离介入战事。
Air defense and drone warfare observed in Ukraine are changing the nature of military helicopter tactics, moving the platform's center of gravity away from the tip of the spear to an emphasis on combat support missions along the front lines.
这边我们看到
Center of gravity
是重心的意思。
The vulnerability of combat helicopters has translated into a high number of losses on the Russian side. In February, a report published by the London-based International Institute for Strategic Studies found that the Russian aerospace forces had lost 40% of their Ka-52 Hokum-B attack helicopter fleet. Russian rotary losses have continued, but changes in tactics and the introduction of new weapons have had an effect.The attack helicopter may have to evolve towards standoff weapons that allow the aircraft to intervene from a greater distance.
这边我们看到
standoff
是战区外的意思。在军语词典中
standoff weapon
是遥攻武器的意思。好的，以上就是今天的节目内容，记得按赞、订阅、追踪、开启小铃铛，看军文学英语，感谢大家的收看，我们下次见。